Start with an example of a geometric random variable. Let's say x is geometric with parameter p. We did binomial last time, you remember that? We did both the method of moments estimator for p and the maximum likelihood estimator for p for a binomial distribution, but now we're talking about a geometric. Do you remember what geometric represents? Number of trials until the first success? Yeah. When you've got, again, the assumption is independent trials that are identical with same probability of success p on each trial. And I don't know if you remember, well, let's think about what would make sense. The expected value of x, let's say I'm rolling a die like you had for your homework. I hope you found an online die simulator or dice simulator if you're rolling two dice at a time. If your probability of success on any roll of, say, getting a one, if you're just talking about one rolling one die, or getting a sum of seven, say, if you're rolling two dice, is 1/6, p would be 1/6, you would think, on average, it should make some intuitive sense that it might take you six trials until you either get a one when you're rolling one die or get a sum of seven when you're rolling two dice. So what's that? That's 1/p, right? 1/1/6. Remember that from chapter 3? That's the expected value of a geometric random variable. With the method of moments, or again, MOM for short, warms your heart, right? This is the MOM method. What do? We replace, why is it called the method of moments? We replace the first moment with a natural estimator for it. If we have a second moment in the equation we're thinking about, we would replace it with a natural estimator for the second moment, which we actually haven't talked about, but I will do the gamma distribution example, so we will talk about that. Method of moments, replace this. Really, this is really a parameter. It's the mean. Replace that moment, that first moment, with a natural estimator. How about x bar? Natural estimator. It's certainly natural. It is a nice estimator in the sense that we've seen it's unbiased. Go ahead and make that replacement. The book also calls this M1, capital M1, as another symbol for an estimator of the first moment. And replace the parameter with a symbol for its estimator that we would like to solve for. And remember, we put a little hat above the parameter to indicate that this is the symbol for the estimator we would like to solve for. And now algebraically solve for that estimator. Oh, that's fairly easy, right? Flip both sides, take reciprocals, or if you prefer, multiply both sides by p hat and divide both sides by x bar. P hat would be 1/x bar. So, if you perform the experiment, let's say with the homework of rolling two dice, and you keep rolling until you get a seven, a sum of seven, maybe the first time it takes you five rolls, maybe the next time it only takes you two rolls, maybe the next time one, maybe the next time it takes you 10 rolls, so you get a sum of seven. So you get a bunch of data, random data, you might say, if you're really shaking vigorously. You get a bunch of numbers that you can average. Maybe the average is 6.3 or something. Take 1/6.3. It would be a little less than 1/6. And that would be your estimate for p. Is p equal to 1/6.3? Well, we would hope it's not. We would hope it's 1/6, right? That's a simple situation where, at least if you do it vigorously, it seems reasonable to say that p should be 1/6 to be a fair roll of two dice. But that would be the estimate that we would get from this estimator. Okay, that would be the method of moments, and it's fairly easy. Here's an even easier example. X is a Poisson distribution, Poisson random variable, with parameter Well, the book initially calls it K. What's the expected value of X? The mean, it's K. So what do we do with the method of moments? Replace the expected value, the moment, with its natural estimator. X bar, replace the parameter with a symbol representing its estimator. There's nothing to do. We're done. There we go. K hat equals X bar. We don't even have to do any algebra. So that's an even easier application of the method of moments. There's really nothing to do besides this one step. All right, let's do a harder example. Let's do the gamma distribution. X is gamma with two parameters. I'll put them in parentheses here, alpha and beta. We'd like to find, we've got two parameters here, right? Alpha and beta. We'd like to estimate both at the same time effectively based on like a data set coming from a, well, we would at least assume it's coming from a gamma distribution. So if we're going to solve for two unknown parameters, estimators for those things, I guess we need two equations. We know the expected value of X, the mean, well, is alpha times beta. Maybe you don't remember that, but that's what it is. We also know the variance is alpha beta squared. If we start trying to apply the method of moments, we could do the same thing here with this first equation, right? Replace the first moment with its natural estimator, X bar. And I guess replace alpha with alpha hat and beta with beta hat. And you could start thinking about doing that here, but you know, really the variance is not a moment, right? But we do know it's related to moments, right? There's the computational formula. It's the second moment minus the square of the first moment. And well, if we used X bar, maybe it'd be kind of confusing. So maybe we should use M1 instead. So, I mean, that could be confusing too, I suppose. But if I'm going to also have a natural estimator for the second moment that I might want to call M2, having an M2 and an X bar in the same system of equations, that could get confusing. So I'll use M1 instead of X bar this time. Replace alpha with alpha hat, replace beta with beta hat. And here, second moment gets replaced with a natural estimator, M2. I haven't said what M2 is. I will, just a minute here. Minus first moment squared equals replace alpha with alpha hat and beta with beta hat. And get that. Okay, so what is M2? Well, remember, M1 is X bar. It's a statistic computed from a random sample. M2 better be a statistic as well. It's supposed to be what you might say is a natural estimator for the second moment. But the second moment is an average expected value. Maybe we should do an arithmetic average here too. It's expected value of X squared. Maybe we should add up the values of the x1 squared, x2 squared, et cetera, and average those, divide by n. Yeah, that's what we do. This is the sum, if we got a sample of size n, of capital Xi squared divided by n. And of course, m1 is the sum, I goes from 1 to n, capital Xi over n. But that's just in the background. Instead, we can just focus on solving this system of equations for alpha hat and beta hat. Now, it's a nonlinear system. In general, nonlinear systems are very difficult to solve, maybe even impossible. But fortunately, this one's not too bad because, look, if we take the second equation and divide by the first, a bunch of stuff cancels, doesn't it? The alpha hats cancel and one of the beta hats cancels. Beta hat would be the ratio alpha hat beta hat squared divided by alpha hat beta hat, right? Because of cancellation. And by these equations, the top is going to be M2 minus, oops, M2 minus M1 squared divided by M1. I guess that's what beta hat is. Now solve for alpha hat. I could take the first equation, divide both sides by beta hat, right? M1 over beta hat, and then replace the beta hat with this thing. And if you do that, you're dividing a fraction, so you get to multiply by the reciprocal. You'll get an M1 squared in the top and an M2 minus M1 squared in the bottom. So what have we concluded here? It seems that this equality right here gives us a method of moments estimator for beta. And this equality right here gives us a method of moments estimator for alpha. Are these unbiased? I don't think I want to try to figure it out. Looks too complicated to try to figure out if these are unbiased. Do you happen to know if they are or not? Maybe it's impossible to say. They're probably not. They're probably too complicated.
They're close. They're good estimates.
They're good estimates. Okay. Probably somewhere, somebody somewhere at some time has tried to quantify how far from being unbiased these things are. You know, that could be something you'd look up as a research project or something. Somebody's probably tried to do it. I don't know how successful they were. Let's try to think about how you would actually apply these ideas. Actually, was that a homework problem where you applied these? I think I might have assigned that problem. You had some data? Yeah. So let's have Mathematica generate some data with random variate, gamma distribution. Oh, let's pick alpha to be 2 and beta to be 3. Sample of size 1,000. We won't look at all the numbers, so I'll put a semicolon there. So we've got 1,000 numbers. I'm not looking at them. I'd like to estimate alpha and beta. I already know the answer, right? Alpha is 2, beta is 3. That's how I did the simulation. So I'm wondering if it's producing data that's consistent with that assumption. This could be something you could test in statistics to see if your simulator is doing a good job or not, possibly. So what should we do here? I guess M1 should be the mean. Okay, this is going to be a number, a decimal number from that particular sample. We got 6.24921. M2, Maybe we can do data squared, mean of data squared. Would that work? Actually, I believe it does. I think if I do data squared, that's not, data is a big list of 1,000 numbers. In Mathematica, if I take a list and I square it like this, I think, if I recall correctly, it squares every number in the list. Does that sound right? I think it does. Maybe we should look at the first data value. First data value is 1. What's the first value of data squared? Oh, that syntax doesn't work. Okay, let's do this. Data squared. Let's try this. 2.57724 squared. Off a little bit because of rounding. It looks like it's doing the right thing. This syntax is picking up the first number in the list. So what's the mean of data squared? This is an arithmetic mean, right? This is adding them up because it's data and dividing them how many there are. 58.6474. So let's see if I do look at the alpha hat first. Compute. M1 squared divided by M2 minus M1 squared. Hopefully it's close to 2. Yeah. And if I compute M2 minus M1 squared divided by M1. Hopefully that's close to 3. All right, looking not too shabby, right? Seems, without doing an official statistical test, seems like it's doing a reasonable job. Okay, that's how you would apply what we've learned here with the method of moments.